requirements page is one of the most important stages in the working process with your clients. Often, it's the first time when clients enter into a dialogue with you. And if you use buyer requirements effectively, you can even get extra sales. Keep watching to find out how. Hello guys, my name is Paulina, and this video is actually a request of one of you. So if you're interested in a specific topic just like this person, don't hesitate to contact me or leave a comment below. But let's get started with the video. Of course, buyer requirements vary a lot from person to person, from field to field, but everything could be combined into one strategy. You simply need to ask yourself, what information do you need to collect to ensure you deliver the highest quality of work? And this is basically the most important thing to consider when creating the requirements for your buyers. I'm a video editor, and if someone asks me, Paulina, what information do you need to collect to ensure you deliver the highest quality of work? My answer probably will be all the files to be used in the project and their short description, a script or a vision of the final result, brand guidelines or personal preferences, technical specifications of the final product, and if the person is interested in the extra services. This is a tricky thing because as much as you want to receive a lot of information from a buyer, you also need to keep in mind that your buyer shouldn't be overwhelmed by the time he spends on reading and filling out everything on the requirements page. You need to find a middle ground. I would say that you shouldn't have more than 3 complicated questions and 5 light ones. By complicated questions, I mean the questions that require a lot of thinking and a long and extensive answer from your buyer. Like, what is your vision on this? And by light questions, I mean multiple choice questions or the questions the answer on which require just one word. For example, which video format do you prefer? MOV, MP4, AV, or other. By the way, I don't know how to pronounce these things correctly. This is just how I pronounce them, so I'm sorry if I'm wrong. Order is also very important because if you want to receive all the required information from a buyer in an accurate form, you need to provide him with the right pathway. This path ensures that the person gets all the needed thoughts on each stop he makes. And the stop is, of course, the question you ask. By the way, guys, if you enjoy watching the video so far, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content like that. Just think about it. If you first ask the person about the color preferences, then about the length of the video, and only then about the footage that he has, this will make chaos in his head. But if you first ask him to provide the files for this project, he'll have a chance to take a look at all the files again and give you a better answer about the length of the video and his color preferences. Do you see why? He just revised everything he has for this project and can now form his vision for the final product much, much easier. In setting up the requirements, consider that your buyer can view them in your gig before purchasing. Like you would with any wording in your gig, you want your writing to be clean to make a great first impression. Also, you need to make sure to align your requirements with the information from your gig description. If you promise something there and you don't address this in the requirements page at all, this will leave a bad impression already at this stage. And we don't want this, right? You maybe heard them saying, you only get one chance to make a first impression. What's more, it's also important to understand that not every buyer will know what exactly he is supposed to do. You can have a client who is using Fiverr for the first time, for example. So you can use this portion of the ordering process to educate the buyer on what to do. Give buyers detailed instructions. If needed, provide the examples of the type of information that you need. For instance, you can ask, please attach your photo and provide instructions on what you would like removed. Please be as specific as possible. The more you give me, the better I can do my job. Buyers like easy communication. And remember, a great communication with your buyer is one of the most important things on Fiverr. By the way, I covered this rule in more details in my previous series, the top 10 advice on how to succeed on Fiverr. You can see the link to the series in the description below. In your buyer requirements, you can leave a requirement to ask where the buyer found your gig. You can leave it open-ended or give them ideas of what you mean. For instance, you can give examples of Fiverr search with certain terms or just a general web search or anything else. The feedback that you receive could be nothing but a huge value for your business. You can keep a detailed record of your sales indicating where the sales came from. There is a chance that you will see that despite your social media presence and promotion, or your portfolio website, most of your sales come from repeat buyers and Fiverr searches. This will suggest that you should focus your efforts on keeping your gigs in great shape. Upselling gig extras can be a real challenge on Fiverr, but in the buyer requirements, you have a unique opportunity of reminding your buyers of your gig extras. I had a lot of situations when people purchased the cheapest package from my gig, and after my suggestions, they also bought like a couple of extras. After this experience, I decided that this would be much more effective and convenient if I simply ask the buyers about my extras on the requirements page. For example, your buyer requirement might read like the following. Would you like to add comments on common grammar mistakes in order to learn how to improve your writing for only $5? Multiple choice options. Absolutely, please send a custom offer. Great idea, but no, thank you. What do you mean? Please tell me more about this. In this sample, you're asking if the client would be interested in an additional service that might be helpful for him. You're giving them a chance to choose their answer and take the appropriate action. This is non-intrusive, so it doesn't put any pressure on your client. And additionally, it's a great way to see if your gig extras are actually attractive to buyers. If you find that your buyers are saying no often, then you may consider removing this extra and trying a different one in its place. Now that you know which things you need to consider when setting up the requirements page for your gig, it's time to take a look at the real example. I'll show you the requirements page that I have for my best-selling gig. If you are a video editor like me, this will really help you. You can even copy the questions that I have. I really don't mind. I'm just happy to help you. And if you're not a video editor, anyway, my requirements page can suggest you a lot of ideas on what to ask in your case. So, this is the gig that I was talking about. It's my best-selling gig and it's about video editing for YouTube channels. Yeah, we will go here in the editing section, and in the editing section we can go to the requirements. So as you can see, I have like 6 questions, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They are very different and we will go one by one. So you'll get a chance to revise everything I told you before and see what I ask my clients. Okay, the first question is, please send me a link or attach the files to this message, to the footage and other materials if needed. So as you can see in the brackets, I mention like examples, so it's much easier for them to understand what I want from them. Also make sure to explain which purpose each file has, a short description of each file. And as I mentioned earlier in the video, it's very important that the first question is about providing the footage because they have a chance to revise everything. So in the second question, I ask them to provide me with a script or a list of specifications for the desired video. And as you can see, I ask them to explain to me as detailed as possible. And I tell them that the more they give me, the better I can do my job. So I give them motivation to share with me as much information as possible. And I explain why I ask it. The third question is, please provide me with your brand guidelines or mention your color, font or style preferences. Pretty straightforward. The next question is also pretty straightforward. What length, quality and size do you want your final video to be? So, and as you can see here, I ask like 3 things, and it's possible to divide these questions into 3 questions. But why I don't do it is just because I think if I divide it into 3 questions, then it will be already like too many questions. It's now already 6. And if I divide these simple questions into 3, it will seem like I have like they need to do a lot of job, and the question is really not that hard. So they basically write, okay, like 10 minutes HD, and I don't care about the size. So, and as you could see, like all the previous questions were like free text, so they didn't have any choices. They could write anything they wanted. And the next question, the 5th question, is already multiple choice. And you can see that there is a lot of things going on, but you will understand why. So I'll do like that. So you could see approximately like my buyers will see this question when they make an order. You can see I tell them that if you purchase my basic or standard package, I want to remind you that none of them includes motion graphics or providing extra materials for a project. If you want to achieve the best possible result, you can purchase these extras. And I suggest them like 3 extras. So I mention what it is and I mention the price already here. And then they have like a lot of choices. It's because, for example, absolutely, please send a custom offer for all of them. Others are like if they want like not to all of them, but just like 1 and 2, 1 and 3, 2 and 3. So you get what I mean. Or if they want just 1 extra, then great idea, but no, thank you. What do you mean? Please tell me more about this. I bought a premium package and don't need music. So of course they have like a lot of options and this maybe scare them a bit, I don't know. But from my experience, it really makes my job and our communication with the buyer
easier and the whole process is just more convenient for both parties. Because after receiving the answer on this question, I already know if I need to send them an extra or if they're not interested at all. And I spend time on messaging them and explaining my extras only if they answer, "What do you mean? Please tell me more about this." Only in this case. So it really saves my time. And the last question is, could you please share where did you find my gig? And as you can see here, I give them examples. So like Fiverr search by using the term recommendation from someone, social media, and so on. So I give them already suggestions so they know what I expect to hear from them. And I also say that this will really help things. So yeah, that's basically it. That's my requirements page for one of my gigs, and basically all other requirements pages for other gigs have the similar outline and have the similar rules that I shared previously. Buyer requirements are more powerful than just their intended use of collecting data about the project. While this is key to giving a high quality product, if you think creatively, your buyer requirements can help you upsell, learn about what gig extras work, and learn how to better market your services based on where your sales came from. Thank you for watching this video, guys. I really hope it was helpful. If I gave you some value, please give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to my channel and also hit the little bell so you can get notifications every time I post a new video to my channel. On this channel, I talk about my life and my interests as a media student, a freelancer, and a video creator, all based in Amsterdam. I really hope to talk with you soon, but for now, пока-пока!